Good morning, everyone. I am Kishore, and we are pursuing the project on automatic human falling trolley using image and video processing under the guidance of Professor Onrajo. And I have my teammates Likit, Hemantraj, and Alubai Hemant Bharat Bhushan.
Very good morning, everyone.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, everyone.
Today, we are going to discuss about these following contents. First is introduction. Here we will be giving a quick introduction about the problem and our approach to solve it. Objective. What are the main objectives or milestones which we have considered to solve the above problem? Implementation details. In this implementation details, we will be clearly explaining how exactly our project flow works and methodology goes and what are all the algorithms we have used. In testing, we have planned for various scenarios and test cases, out of which we have done some of the sum. And the remaining ones, we will be giving a quick overview. Result, we will be explaining how exactly our project is working right now. And current work status, we have completed nearly 80 to 90% of the work till now. Pending work, here we are going to discuss about the work to be completed. Going on to next slide.
Yeah. So coming to the introduction of our project, yeah, we have discussed about it in the previous milestones or in the previous days. So I'm going to just give a quick overview of our project. Yeah, in the present world, we are using the trolleys to carry the goods which are pushed or pulled by applying the human strength or the physical strength. This is what the problem we have chosen. And for this, we have proposed the solution that we could make an automated trolley which follows the human automatically. And of course, there were previous systems which were existing. That means they were not in use, but they were in the research phase that they were following using some sensors, all those things. So there were some problems associated with such systems. They were using many sensors, which indirectly affects the efficiency of the project or the system, because if one sensor fails, the entire system may fail. So we have come to an idea that why can't we use image processing and video processing, these techniques and these algorithms to follow the human. By keeping this in mind, we have proposed this system where we are designing or we are implementing the system that image processing and video processing algorithms are used such that by using a camera, a single camera can act as every different sensor which were used in the previous system. And by using these techniques, the trolley will automatically follow the human. This is what the proposed system. And moving on with the further slide. Yeah. This session or this section which we are going to discuss is objectives. Of course, we have talking about or we have speaking about this objective from previous semester itself. These are certain things, that is milestones, which we are considered as important things which have to be considered and which have to be solved step by step to achieve the solution for the previous question or the problem which I had quoted. So what are the different objectives we have considered? Is first one is to design a human following trolley using image and video processing. As I said before, there were previous systems which were using some sensors, etc. So despite of those things, we have to design our own model or our own system by using image and video processing. It have to follow the user. And why we have considered this design as one of the objective? Because this design plays an important role, because if the design of the trolley, that is the carrier or maybe the camber or maybe some other wheels or caster wheel or some other wheels which isn't placed correctly in the system, this may affect to the performance of that system. So we have considered this design as one of our objective and worked on it.
Yeah, so coming to the detection of the sticker from the input image and video by eliminating background and noise. Here, detection of the sticker is nothing but a sticker will be provided for each trolley and having a unique sticker which has to be identified and then followed. So here in this sticker will be provided for the user, and if the sticker is detected, then it is the user that is detected and recognized. So detection of the sticker from the input image also plays an important and major role in our project. So we have considered this as one of the objectives.
Yes, moving on to the next objective, that is the recognition of the detected user to be followed. Yes, as we have just detected the sticker now. So as I said before, the next comes the recognition part. So here the recognition is nothing but, so the detected sticker should be recognized by the trolley. That means, so the trolley should know whom it should follow. So like you can consider many scenarios, like in case of shopping malls. So if there are any disturbances, like any other person or any other sticker comes in front of the trolley that are not, that should not be recognized. So there should be correctness in the following. So we are using the recognition of the detected sticker, so which is nothing but the detected user in there. And hence, we have considered it as one of the major objectives since it is the main part in our project.
The next objective is maintaining constant distance between user and the trolley by avoiding collision. Now we have come to the consequence that there might be a collision between the user and the trolley. To avoid such collision, we have considered it as an objective. Moving on to next slide.
Yeah, coming to the implementation details part. So here in this section, we will be explaining in detail of how our project is implemented. So what are the different techniques we have used and how exactly the flow works, all those things. So coming to methodology here, it is a quick overview of the entire working of our project. So first, the system will be started, okay? So there is a camera fixed in front of the trolley as earlier in the design part. So and it captures the image or video, so which is in front of it. So next comes the detection part. As we have said, as one of the important objective is detection. So actually here, detection of the sticker, so from the captured image is being performed. What we have planned here is a unique sticker will be assigned to the trolley. And that sticker will be provided so for the user who wants to use the trolley. So here the sticker may be like some green or red colored like symbols, so and etc. So as we have as of now, so we have planned to give the green colored sticker for the detection and recognition purpose. So this sticker is provided to the user, and this sticker should be shown to the camera, and it captures the image by using some detection algorithms. So this sticker will be detected finally. Next, coming to the recognition of the sticker. So once the sticker is detected, so every time when there is the same, when the same sticker is in front of the trolley, so the sticker should be recognized, which means so there may be many disturbances that I have already told, like in shopping malls and hospitals, some other stickers or some other persons or some other things. So maybe in front of the trolley and the camera maybe captured it. So it should not be, it should be considered as junk values and it should be neglected. Only the detected sticker should be recognized and followed. And here we have used some algorithms to do so. Next, the trolley should follow the user by maintaining the constant distance as said earlier. So as we have said, one of the objectives is to avoid the collision by maintaining the constant distance. So for this, we have used some distance estimation techniques. So for the trolley to maintain the constant distance between the user and the trolley. So this techniques will be used to achieve the constant distance between the user and the trolley. Then once the use of the trolley is finished, so it should be stopped. So it is nothing but showing some red colored stickers or moving the detected sticker away from the trolley. So which means the system will be going to stop. So this is about the methodology or what we can say the data flow of our work process of our entire project. So moving on further.
Yeah, so coming to the algorithms which we have used to achieve those objectives, and one of the important algorithm we have used is background subtraction algorithm. Here we have some idea about regarding this background subtraction algorithm. So there will be an input image, and first we are giving you a quick overview of background image algorithm. Here we will provide an input image or a video frame where the part which has to be detected is present with the other background images in that present. So first it will be pre-processed, then a background modeling will be happening, and the only part that has to be detected is considered as the foreground, and rest other things will be considered as the background, and foreground will be masked and considered for processing. This is how background subtraction algorithm works, and in our project we have implemented this as a sticker is considered as a foreground part. Only those things should be recognized and detected for further processing, and rest other things present in that video frame or camera frame should be considered as a background. So this is how this background subtraction algorithm is implemented in our project. So moving on to the next slide.
Yeah, the next algorithm, we can't quote it as an algorithm, but this is a technique which we have used to extract the color or extract the image of the sticker from the input frame. And this is nothing but determining the HSV value of the sticker. Yeah, you may ask the question, what is this HSV value? This HSV is nothing but there are various color models like RGB color model, CMY color model. Likewise, this is HSV, which is one of the color model. It is quoted as hue saturation value. You might have the question, why can't we use RGB only? Why not the CMY? RGB is nothing but red, green, blue, and its variants of colors. And CMY, cyan, magenta, and yellow, and its variants of colors. Of course, we can use those color models also. But in the real time or in the real life, there are various colors. Not only red, green, blue, or its variants. There are some other colors. And if that color is held in light, that means if the saturation is different, this might appear as different color for our eye. So therefore, this HSV value or this HSV color model appears to be more realistic for our eye or for our life. So we have using this HSV value or HSV color model for our project. And how exactly we have implemented in our project means this HSV, there is an image which is showing in the first value, hue saturation value. This hue is nothing but the range of colors and its variants. And saturation is amount of light falling on it due to which it is maybe the amount of cement color present in the red light or amount of white color present in the red light, which makes that red light to appear differently. This is nothing but hue and saturation. And it consists of various range of values. That is, the red falls from 0 to 60. And the yellow is the yellow will be detected, or the yellow color falls from 61 to 120 degrees. And 121 to 180, it will be green. And 181 to 140 degree, it will 240 degree, it will be cyan. And 241 to 300, blue. And 301 to 360 degree, magenta. And these 0 to 60, I quoted as red means not only red, its other variants, maybe the orangish red, dark red, all those things will be present in this range. And not only these hue value, it is adding some saturation to it. When some amount of light is up, 100% of light is fall apart on this red, how it will be going to visualize. All those things can be calculated and all those values can be got through this HSV model. So we are using HSV value for our project. And how it is implemented means previously Hemant explained about the background subtraction. Only the foreground or the object which has or the sticker which has to be detected will be considered as the foreground and masked. The rest other things should be neglected. So for this, the sticker, as we said, it is a colored sticker, maybe the green color sticker or the red color sticker. But as of now, for the experimentation, we have used a green color sticker. And this green color sticker should be considered as a foreground. So to extract this green color sticker from the input frame or the video frame, we are using this. And only this part will be extracted and it is masked. And the rest other things which is present in the input frame could be neglected. And there is one example where we are detecting the blue colored circles. In the input image, there are red, orange, all other things. But we are giving the HSV value of this blue color only, so that only blue color circles are detected and the rest of the things are unmasked or treated as a background and eliminated. And this masked value is further used for recognition and following purposes. This is what about HSV color model and what technique we have used or implemented in our project. Moving on with the further algorithm.
Yeah. To give a quick overview of the algorithm, this is used to calculate the distance between user and the trolley. Why we are using this algorithm is to avoid the collision between user and the trolley. Here is the formula for it. X and Y are the coordinate values of camera and the object. In our project, how we have implemented here is, we have used the yellow cardboard now. For the real project, we will be using green sticker. So this algorithm calculates the distance from that sticker to the camera. And we have fixed the distance to 1 meter right now. This will be calculated for every image taken from the camera. Once the object is out of 1 meter distance, trolley moves forward until the distance becomes 1 meter, and it stops at the distance 1 meter, avoiding collision. This is how distance estimation works in our project. Moving on to next slide.
Yeah, so here we have proposed a basic model which follows a unique colored sticker whose value is already stored in the program. So we have come to the testing part where we have proposed a basic model which follows a unique color sticker which whose value is already stored in program. So we have considered some possibilities where keeping the camera position and carrier position in different places of the trolley. So we have also tested out, and of which we have come to one specific and good result is camera should be placed in front of the trolley and carrier is placed in the back of the trolley. This design of the model works efficient compared to other positions we have tested. So we have tested these possible designs and finalized for this design as a new design to be finalized. So coming to the next phase, the testing has to be conducted that is efficiently follows the same unique sticker without any confusion. So as I said, sticker will be detected from the camera's image. The trolley should detect the sticker present in the image, and if other objects or stickers is present in the same image, it should not have any confusions. So that is, we have to test the furthermore scenarios, maybe by giving two or three stickers which are quite similar but not exactly the same. At this time, only the sticker which we want the trolley to detect, only that has to be detected, and other stickers should be neglected. All these things we have to test. As of now, we have not done those testings. Hence, we have planned to do that further.
Yeah, moving on to the next one, testing part, that is only the given sticker is recognized and all the other objects that is in front of the camera should be treated as background and further or later eliminated or subtracted. Yes, as we have said, background subtraction is used because once when the camera captures the image or video, there are various things, as I said earlier, in the background. Like in case of consider, for example, shopping malls, there may be some people who are wandering in between, and or some other trolleys may be present. So in the video frame, which is captured by our trolley's camera. So out of which only the sticker part need to be detected, and the other things should be kept as a background, and it should not be used for those things. We have to test the trolley in different scenarios. So maybe by taking the trolley inside the shopping malls itself, and giving various inputs there, or by taking it to the hospitals, we have to do these test cases yet. We have not completed this, and we have planned to perform these test cases in the further days. Yes, the next one is that there should not be any collisions with the user. Yes, as I said before, there should be a constant distance that is maintained between the user and the trolley. And for it, we have to test various scenarios that when the user moves, if the user moves very faster and the trolley should move at the same speed or increase the speed in order to maintain the constant distance between him and the trolley. And suddenly, if the user stops and the trolley should stop, all those things should be tested. And yes, we have tested some part of it till now. The trolley responding quite good. Okay. But still, we have to make it much efficient by taking many scenarios. As I said before, like taking it to the shopping malls, hospitals, etc. So, and by giving some more inputs like moving faster, suddenly stopping, and moving slower. So all those things should be considered in this case. So we are testing it further.
Yeah, this is what in the testing phase, of course, we have a lot of work to do since we haven't tested it completely. But out of 100%, we are sure that it is working 80% efficiently. But still, we have to test in the different scenarios, maybe in shopping malls, maybe in hospitals, etc. And these above points which they have mentioned till now is what we are planning to test this system. Of course, when we design a system, it has to be working efficiently to avoid some consequences of collision, etc. It has to be tested. And to avoid this collision and to avoid this collision and other consequences, the system should be much efficient and it should be taking immediate decisions. Maybe when the person is moving fast and suddenly he stops, the trolley should also suddenly stop. It has to cope up the speed with the person in front of him. So all these actions should be taken immediately So this can be achieved by implementing much efficient algorithm. As of now, what we have implemented, we are testing it and the system is working efficiently. So still we have to test in the different scenarios, whether it work in the hospitals or in the same efficiency only or not. This has to be tested. And this is what we are planning of testing. And next comes what we are tested till now is. This is one of the test case. As we said, only the colored sticker should have to be detected and it has to be masked. So we are tested that, you can see the camera input image where it has a laptop in front of the camera and wall frame, all those things. And in fact, there is a hand of the person holding, the Hemant is holding that, and it is a yellow cardboard. As we said, we are presently, we worked by using this yellow cardboard and to detect this yellow cardboard. So the final result, you can see that only the yellow cardboard region is detected and the rest of the things are not detected. I mean, it is subtracted from the input image. This is what we were trying to do in the background suppression. The rest other things other than the sticker which is detected should be treated as the background and it should be eliminated. This is one of the test cases which has passed yet, but still we have to give the input image by keeping another one object in front of the camera only, by keeping this cardboard away from the camera, how it will work. All those things should have to be tested. This is what regarding the testing phase and test cases and which we have planned and which we have done. Moving on further.
Coming to the results, since we have taken the designing of the trolley as an objective, here is an image of the design of our system. Due to lockdown, we are not able to provide the big trolley. So we have just designed a basic model which is working efficiently. This trolley consists of two normal wheels and one caster wheel, and chassis is provided for the trolley, upon which camera is mounted in front of the trolley and the carrier is placed the back side of the trolley. We have tried various other designs like placing the carrier in front and placing the camera behind, out of which this design is more feasible, and the Raspberry Pi is placed below the or under the chassis so that it is not visible. This is the basic design of our project.
Yeah, so coming to the detection process, the unique sticker is placed in front of the camera and it is detected, and rest of the objects in the image is treated as the background and eliminated. And as said by Hemant Raj, only the colored sticker is to be detected and the background should be subtracted. And here is the final output that is given by the camera. So you can see a camera input in the first picture where I'm holding a cardboard of yellow color, and the next box represents an HSV representation of that same image. So as to hue saturation value, only a yellow color sticker is actually detected and the background is going to be eliminated. Yeah, coming to the color mask, where only the color sticker is to be masked and other background images present should be eliminated. And considering all these things, and final result that is coming out is the only yellow color sticker that has to be recognized and not the other images. So this is the detection process we have come across till now, and furthermore we are testing it. So moving on.
Maintaining constant distance from the user. As we have said, we have used distance estimation technique to achieve this. Here is the output video on the screen. Here the trolley is given input how exactly it is working. Things are shown. When cardboard is placed in front of the camera, it starts recording. And when it is moved further away from the camera, it's showing forward. That is, both wheels are moving close to close the distance. And when the cardboard is moved right, the trolley also moves right. And when the cardboard is moved left, the trolley also moves left. And when the cardboard is stopped at the exact distance, the trolley movement stops to avoid collision. This is how constant distance is maintained in our project. Moving on to next slide.
Yeah, coming to the current work status of our project. current work status of our project. Firstly, we have designed the trolley. Not to say much on this, as we have quoted in the result section itself. So we have completed this design part of the trolley. So earlier a month or so. So we have completed design part and coming to the implemented line follower trolley. So yes, the next we have implemented the line follower trolley after the design part is completed. Here we may have questions that why what's the use of this line follower trolley in our project? So here our first idea is to have, so if the trolley can follow the line, so why can't it follow the human by changing some inputs or some methodologies? So we have done this as a first working step, and using this we are trying to achieve the final end result.
Controlling the movements of the trolley by giving manual inputs. As we can see in the video, I am giving manual inputs. When I give forward arrow key, the trolley is moving forward. And when I press the right arrow key, the trolley is moving right. And when I press the left arrow key, it moves left. And when I press the back arrow key, it also moves back. These things we have controlled by giving manual inputs to make that video.
Yeah, so coming to the next status where the detection of the sticker from the video. Here, as I had told before, the detection of the sticker from the video or image is done. And you can see in the second video where I am actually using the cardboard box to make the trolley move. Yeah, you can see the wheels rotating if I go to the left or if I go to the right or if I go forward. And if I go near to the trolley actually stops moving. And this is how the detection of the sticker and the project is currently working. So maintaining a constant distance and follow the user. Yeah, so as I am turning the cardboard to the left, to the right, and going forward, the car, the trolley is also following the same instructions. And if I also go and try and make the cardboard actually go present it in a very nearby way, then the trolley stops. So that is they are maintaining the constant distance, and this is how this project is currently working.
This is what we are worked, that is the current work progress. Yeah, you might have asked, you could have made a video by keeping the trolley down and made it to follow you, but due to some inefficient power supply, we are working on it, how much power has to be given so that it could efficiently move the trolley. We are working it. So what are the pending work means? We need to test the system for different test cases. As we said in the testing, by explaining the testing phase, we have planned of different testing, by testing in the hospitals, by testing in the shopping malls, as we have kept our boundary, these two. We have to go there and test the system, but due to this lockdown and other things, we couldn't do it yet, but we have to do it, and it is, we have kept it as a pending work. And not only by going there, we have to test whether the system is working correctly or taking the immediate decisions by giving some other outputs and some other inputs, maybe by keeping much objects in the input frame so that the camera has to detect the only the detection sticker which has to be detected. We have to test all those things. And
in another episode, Siriya.
Ilaila.
Hello.
Bharat. ಇವಾಗ ಇದು ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಗೆ ಪ್ಲಾನ್ ಇದು ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ರೋಬೋಟ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಸೆನ್ಸರ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಟ್ರಾಲಿಗು ಇದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಟ್ರಾಲಿಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್
ಸದ್ಯಕ್ಕೆ
1 meter ಅದನ್ನ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ
ಸಾರಿ
ಅದಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಸರ್ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ನೋ ಆಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡತ್ತೆ ಸರ್
ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದು ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ನಲ್ಲ ಡಿಲೆ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರ
ಹಾ ಸರ್ ಡಿಲೇ ರೆಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ ನಾವು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಅದು ಕ್ಯಾಮ್ರಾದು ಸಖತ್ತು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಯಾಮ್ರಾ ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋಗಿ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಅದು ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ಯಾಮ್ರಾಯಿಂದ ಸರ್ಟನ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ 2 meters ಏನೋ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಸ್ಟಾಪ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್
ಸರಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೀವು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಹೇಮಂತ್ ಸರ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಡೌಟ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರು ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಹೋದ್ರು ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಎಂಡ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸರ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
Okay.